Yes, and with this I shall complete my infinity gauntlet of earbuds. But wait, I only have 5 fingers. How does that work anyways? Well, as you can see, I have a lot of different earbuds here today. I have the Jaybird Vistas, I have the Jabra 75 Elite Actives, I also have some good old-fashioned AirPods, and I'm guessing that if you just joined me, you're probably trying to figure out what the best earbuds are on the market today. Now, trust me when I say I've done a lot of research on this topic, and I've whittled it down to what I believe are the 2 best options, not just for audiophiles, but also for runners and for gym goers out there. So the 2 products that we're going to be comparing today are the Jaybird Vistas and the Jabra Elite Active 75Ts. So if you're interested in seeing which one wins the head-to-head comparison, stay tuned, and we're gonna talk about all the features coming right up. Alrighty, so hi, welcome to another One Life to Live product review. I'm your host, David Vanderhayden, and today we'll be comparing the 2 best options for gym goers and audiophiles alike. We have the $180 Jaybird Vistas and the $200 Jabra Elite 75T active versions. The active version is the more waterproof version. Now, the first thing I want to point out is that I've been watching some other YouTube reviews, and they all reviewed the Jabra 65T Elite and the 65T Active, but not the brand new 75T Actives. The 75Ts is the upgraded model, and that has a better battery life, a snugger fit, and improved water resistance. Now, if you're interested in the cheaper 65T or 75T Elites that aren't the active version, check out this little table that I made here, and it will compare the different models and different price options for you guys. Now, the 75T actually has an IP57 rating, which puts them right on par with Jaybird Vistas as the 2 most waterproof earbuds on the market today. And by the way, there are other earbuds out there that are waterproof, like, for example, the Plantronic Backbeat Fits that I bought back in 2017, which still work to this day, but they are not truly wireless. They are IP57 rated, which means that they can be submerged underwater though, so they're a pretty good option if you want to check that out. Anyways, so let me give you like a 1-minute background on my history with earbuds. If you want to skip ahead in the video, go ahead, I'll give you the timestamp right here. But basically, I had a pair of Jaybird X2s back in the day, and they had that little wire in the back that was kind of annoying as you're running, it would kind of bounce around, but they were a really good pair of headphones. And then I accidentally put them in the washer, so I don't recommend that. They're not that waterproof. And so I basically went in the market, was looking for some other earbuds that would be just as good and that were completely waterproof, and I arrived at the Backbeat Fits by Plantronic. And these I've had for the last 3 years, they've been holding up pretty well, but as you can see, they're not truly wireless. So I wanted to see what were the best options out there for true wireless earbuds. And ever since Apple put out the AirPods Pro, there's been some stiff competition on the market for true wireless earbuds. I actually tried out some true wireless earbuds about a year or 2 ago, and actually it was a couple years ago, and I found that they didn't have very good Bluetooth connection, so I actually didn't stick with them. But now that these earbuds are using Bluetooth 5.0, really don't have any dropouts, so I figured I might as well give these another shot and see which ones are the best ones on the market today. So in the beginning of the video, I showed you guys that I had a pair of Apple AirPods, and you might be wondering why I'm not going to be comparing the head-to-head comparison of these with maybe the Jabras or the Jaybirds. Well, I think that the Jaybirds and the Jabras are better than the AirPods, and they're better than the AirPods Pro, and they actually cost less. Now, you'd think that with Apple releasing these new and improved AirPod Pros, they'd be the gold standard that you compare things to, but they actually fell short for a number of reasons, and I'm going to talk about that. When you pay for Apple products, you're paying for the premium, and you're paying for that Apple brand name. And the AirPod Pros are a great product, but you shouldn't just mindlessly buy them because you're an Apple user. You pay a premium, but really when there's cheaper earbuds out there that have more features and they're getting beat in just about every category except for maybe noise cancellation with the active noise cancellation, I just don't see it that it's worth it. So I personally think noise cancellation is a little bit overhyped. You don't need it that much if you have a really tight fit. And that passive noise cancellation is more than enough to block out noises. You don't really need the active noise cancellation, and it's not really worth the extra $50 to $70 that you'd be paying just for that feature on the Apple AirPods Pro. For that reason, I'm gonna knock out the AirPod Pros. So without further ado, Let's try to compare these two earbuds using an old-fashioned scorecard. I got a whole bunch of categories. We're gonna tally them all up, and at the end of the video, we're gonna see who the winner is. But let me just say before we start, I love both of these headphones, okay? Neither one is a bad choice, and really, you can't go wrong with either one. But I had to decide on a winner, and without trying them in person, I wasn't really sure, so I had to buy both of them. And after using them both daily for the last couple of weeks, I'm pretty confident in my choice. So let's roll the main categories. Our first category, of course, is gonna be battery life. Now, battery life is one of those things that some people will say is the most important thing. And I think that honestly, nowadays, as long as you get at least 5 hours of battery, you're good. So to give you a reference point, the AirPods only give you 5 hours, and the AirPods Pro only give you 4.5 hours of battery time. So anything over 5 hours is more than enough, especially with the case nearby at all times. So with 7.5 hours for the Jabra Elite Active 75Ts, that's pretty good. And for the Vistas, you get 6 hours, okay? And then you get 28 hours total with the Jabras, and you get 16 total with the Vistas. If you're really gonna factor in the case and the total time that's allotted for all these different models of different earbuds, the Jabras has the best, it's 28 hours. That's even better than the Galaxy Buds, because the Galaxy Buds Plus have 11.5 hours on a single use, but their total time is less than the Jabras, okay? So the Jabras have the best total time, the Galaxy Buds have the best single use time, but again, the Galaxy Buds are not waterproof. So the Jaybird Vistas will last for 6 hours, and the Jabra 75Ts will last for 7.5 hours. So at first glance, you're thinking, okay, the Jabras clearly have the Jaybirds beat out. But for those runners out there, you might have a dead pair of headphones and you might wanna go out for a run. Well, the Jaybirds actually have a special feature where they charge really fast if you just give them 5 minutes of charge. So for a 5 minute charge time, you can get an hour of playback on the Jaybirds, which is actually pretty amazing. And the Jabra website does not give a stat for that. The only stat that they give for quick charge time is like if you charge these for 15 minutes, you get an hour of playback. So 5 minutes of playback, or 5 minutes of charge gives you an hour of playback on the Jaybirds, and for the Jabras, you only get, it takes you 15 minutes. So I decided to actually do some tests of my own, and we're gonna pull up my notes here and see what we found out. So basically I did a test and I charged the Jabras for 5 minutes, just like I did with the Jaybirds, and the Jaybirds do last up to an hour like they claim. But when I tested out the Jabras, I actually found pretty similar results to the Jaybirds. So I tested them out and they lasted 41 minutes, 55 minutes, and 41 minutes again. And I kept running these tests and I usually got around 40 plus minutes on these, but not quite the full hour. So they're not as good as the Jaybirds for lasting an hour off that 5 minute quick charge, but they're not that bad. And in 5 minutes, 15 minutes, it's like, it's not that big of a deal, but if you're in those tight kind of pinch situations where you really want to go out for a run really fast and you only need like, you only have like 5 minutes before you have to go, these do have an edge over the Jabras. But honestly, I think that's splitting hairs a little bit, and I think that Jabra should probably put that on their website that it's a little bit variable, but it can get up to an hour off of five minutes of charge. I got 55 minutes at one time, so that's not bad. And I think it does depend on also like how much the case is charged up. So I think somewhere I remember reading that the Jaybirds, they require at least this has to be charged at least 50% in order to get that quick charge time. But I could be wrong. Maybe I'm confusing that. But anyways, if I had to really boil it down to say who's the winner, it's a tough call because the Jaybirds have that quick charge feature and they have pretty similar times of 7.5 to 6 hours for the regular battery life. It's really not kind of splitting hairs a little bit there, but I mean, if you're really trying to say who's the winner, I'd have to say it's the Jabra 75Ts, but I'm almost tempted to give both of these a check in the category, but I'm gonna give it to the Jabra 75Ts for this one. So our second category is gonna be waterproofing. And that's a really important feature. I think that's probably one of the most important features for somebody who goes to the gym or somebody who sweats profusely all over these things, because they can actually stop working and you gotta freak out and put them in rice if you don't have good waterproofing. And all the other earbuds out there that are really expensive don't have good waterproofing. Now, so for something to be really truly waterproof, they have to have a level 7 IP rating. And if we want to get into the details of it, there's actually two numbers that they give for IP ratings. The first number is the solid rating. So that's going to tell you like if it gets dust or solid objects in there, the grit and dust, That's gonna tell you how dustproof it is. And then the second number is gonna tell you how waterproof it is. And that's the most important number in my opinion, because you want them to be more than just splash-proof or spill-proof. You want them to be IP7 rated, which means that if you submerge them underwater for 30 minutes, they're gonna be completely fine. So if you drop them in a puddle, it'll be fine. If you get stuck out in the middle of the rain, they're gonna be fine. If you go swimming and you forget that they're in there for a second and you take them off real quick, you'll be fine. Now, one thing that confused me when I first started shopping for these two products is that the Jaybird Vistas, I thought, had a better waterproof rating than the Jabras. But actually, if you look at them, they both have a level 7 waterproof rating. And the reason why I got confused was because that first number that the Jaybirds listed was an X, okay? And that meant that they haven't been tested for their dustproof rating, basically. So if you're a rock climber or something like that, technically, they haven't been tested for dust and stuff like that. So if you get chalk in there, it hasn't been certified. But I mean, come on, if they're waterproof, they're probably gonna be dustproof as well. But another reason why I got confused was also the fact that the Jabras, the previous model, only had a level 6 rating, okay? So I thought that they weren't gonna have the level 7 rating like the Jaybirds did. Now, one thing that we should probably mention is that if you're a swimmer out there, you probably shouldn't be swimming in either of these. And the reason for that is because, number one, Bluetooth doesn't really work transmitting through water, okay? It's just not a medium that transmits well through water. And if you're gonna be listening to these underwater, you're not gonna hear anything. So it doesn't matter how waterproof they are if you can't hear the music. And the second reason why you wouldn't want to swim in these is because they're not approved for harsh chemicals, okay? So when they do these IP test ratings, they don't factor in the chlorine in the water or salt water, for example. They're for fresh water. And that means that you should also not take them in the shower and run all of your soap and all that stuff all over them. Although you can wear them in the shower. And as you can see in this footage here, I did test them out in the shower. So you're welcome for that. The reason why I took them in the shower was because I wanted to see if I took them out in a torrential downpour when I was out on a run, or if I was sweating profusely, and sometimes that happens when you're doing those HIIT style workouts, okay? Would they last and would they actually stay waterproof? And the answer is yes. And they both have a really tight seal, but if you completely dunk yourself underwater, you're gonna lose that tight seal a little bit. And one thing that I do like about the Jabras is they have a really tight fit. They have the tightest fit. In fact, they have an even tighter fit than their previous model, the 65Ts, because they have like this kind of this silicone rubber material that they put in the middle that makes them really snug, and they're not gonna fall out, okay? Okay, so let's get on to category number 3, which is Bluetooth range and connectivity. So both of these have really good range on them, and they both have Bluetooth 5.0. One of the problems that I had with my previous true wireless earbuds that I only tried out for like a week or so before I decided they weren't worth it is they kept having dropouts, okay? And you'll never have dropouts or lag with Bluetooth 5.0 products. So that's probably the biggest selling point versus the products from a few years ago. I would go to put like my phone in my pocket or something like that, and sometimes the music would skip. And that was just not acceptable as a runner or as someone who goes to the gym or just really for any reason. So both of these have great range. You're not gonna be able to like go the length of a football field or something like that, but you should be able to go a decent amount of distance. And from my testing, like when I left these down in my basement and I went upstairs into the kitchen to go do things, or if I went even one level further up into my room or something like that, they still didn't drop out. So if you're just one level away and you have a wall in between you, they still stay connected, which is pretty good. And I don't think you're gonna have any issues whatsoever when it comes to Bluetooth range on these. And for that reason, I'm gonna have to give both of these a win in this category. So again, it's a tie, and let's move on to the next category. So I wasn't really sure what to call this next category, but I'm gonna go ahead and call it noise cancellation and safety, okay? And the reason why we're gonna talk about those two together is because both of these earbuds do a really good job of noise canceling, okay? It's essentially like wearing earbuds in your ear, except they play music into your ear, okay? So I like the really tight seal of these, and that's for that reason, I don't think either one of these needs active noise cancellation, because when I was listening to music, I couldn't hear anything around me. Even when I didn't hear any music, I still couldn't hear people talking around me. And that could be a problem when it comes to safety. And the one thing that I really like about the Jabra Elite Active 75Ts is the fact that they have hear-through technology. So hear-through technology, also known as like ambient awareness or pass-through technology, basically means that it has microphones on the earbud that allow me to hear my surroundings. And that's really important because if I'm out running or if I'm out, you know, lifting in a gym and somebody's trying to get my attention, I need them to be able to get my attention while I'm still listening to the music. And when I wear the Jaybirds, the passive noise cancellation is so good that I can't hear anything around me. And it kind of makes me a little bit worried that I'm gonna get hurt. So let me give you a couple examples, okay? So say that you're going out for a run and you have a car coming up behind you. In that case, you'd wanna tap on the hear-through technology so that you can hear the cars coming up behind you and you don't get killed by a drunk driver, okay? Now, on the other hand, I go running sometimes right down by the street, and there's this one particular section of the road where it's really loud when I'm out running, and I actually turn the hear-through off for that because I don't want to hear these cars whizzing by, and the microphone will actually pick that up and amplify it, and I don't want to have to hear those cars. So it's actually really nice, even within the same run, when I'm running along a sidewalk by the road, I turn it off, but then when I'm on the main roads and I don't want to get hit by a car, I turn the hear-through on, and then I'm protected from danger. So it's a really good feature. So pass-through technology is becoming a really big deal, and in my opinion, it's much more important than active noise cancellation. And this is because earbuds nowadays form such a tight seal, they're essentially earplugs that play audio. So you won't even have to use active noise cancellation, even though it's a cool feature. And in the future, I'd anticipate that all buds will have the pass-through technology because they keep you safe. Like when I first bought them, I wasn't really sure that the hear-through technology would be a big deal, but after using them, I think it actually is a really big deal. I think the hear-through technology keeps me safe, and having that option to switch it on or off is great. So I think in that regard, I have to say that for this category, the Jabras totally win with the hear-through technology, even though technically they both have really good passive noise cancellation. So let's move on to our next category, which is comfort and fit, okay? So both of these earbuds are, I would say, very comfortable and they fit very snugly. But when I first tried on the Jaybirds, I went on the treadmill and I put them in, and I just put them in just like this, okay? I slotted them in and then I started running on the treadmill. Now what I should have done was I should have twisted them just a little bit. Now that's in the instructions that you're supposed to twist them on. And when you do that, they actually form a really tight seal. But when I first tried them on, they started, I started sprinting really hard and they actually started to fall out. And I went, wow, these things suck. They actually don't live up to their advertisement, which is that they have this really tight seal. And I was kind of disappointed. But if you realize how to put them in, they require just a little twist, and then boom, there you go. You got them in just how you need them. I think that if you don't like doing that little twist feature, the Jaybirds are definitely for you. They don't require you to do a little twist. You just stick them right on there. And it's weird because like they fit slightly looser, I would say, but they don't move around at all. And one of the reasons why they don't move around at all is because they have these little fins on them. And it's kind of weird because the fin itself is supposed to fit right up against your ear, like right like that. And it tucks in right on this part of your ear, so they're not gonna move around, which is kind of funny because they do stick out, in my opinion, slightly more than the Jabras. Let me put in the Jabras so you guys can see what that looks like, okay? So here we have the Jabras, and in my opinion, the Jabras don't stick out as much. Here's a side-by-side comparison. Okay, let me see if I can get my head straight. So the Jabras are advertised as being like this incredibly tight fit, and they have like this improved new model where like the inner part of it is supposed to fit in there extra snug. But the Jaybirds have never come close to falling out. I actually have had the Jabras fall out a little bit. So I would say the Jaybirds probably do stay in there slightly better. But honestly, the only time I've ever had the Jabras fall out is when I've done something like this. There it goes. Okay, so if you try to do a crazy banger test, it's not gonna work, okay? If you're not doing headbanging, doesn't really matter, but if you do some headbanging and listen to some crazy music, you're probably gonna go with the Jaybirds. Okay, so that's kind of a crazy example, doing the headbanger test, but I never had the Jabras fall out when I was doing like intense sprints or when I was doing push-ups or doing squats or really anything like that. So I don't think that you're gonna have an issue here, but just make sure that when you put them in, you gotta really screw them in, otherwise they won't stay tight. Another problem that I had with the Jabras is that occasionally occasionally I would have to just kind of take them out and they would get kind of like itchy on the inside of my ear because they're such a tight fit and you really got to screw them in there. So all I would have to do is just take them out maybe once every 15 minutes or so and just kind of like scratch my ear by sticking my finger in my ear for a little bit, and then it went away and then I just put them back in there. Also, ear fatigue. I find that both of them do give you ear fatigue after a long period of time. I feel like my ears personally were less fatigued by the Jaybirds. So if I had to give a winner in this category, I'd probably say it's the Jaybirds. So our next category is call quality. And I'm gonna try and make this one pretty quick because in my opinion, call quality really isn't that big of a deal. Unless you're someone who's gonna be using this for like conference calls and you spend a better part of the day on the phone, I think that really you should probably try to find something that has a microphone right up against your mouth, because honestly, when the mic is this far from your mouth, it's not gonna sound that great no matter what you have. But if I'm gonna have to compare these two products, the Jaybirds only have one microphone and the Jabras have four microphones that are all inserted in there. Now, part of the reason they have that is probably for the hear-through technology, but since it has four mics, technically four mics are better than one. So just from a technical standpoint, since the Jabras have four mics, I'm gonna have to give them a check as the winner in this category, but really, I didn't really hear that much of a difference when I did my call quality test, because phone calls just don't sound that good in general. So I don't know, I guess it's up to you guys, unless you're using this for maybe doing like a web chat with somebody where it's a little bit more sensitive and you're not losing as much call quality or as much audio quality in general from the microphone. So that's a toss up, but let's move on to our next category. Okay, so before we go on anymore, there's a really important category that we have to talk about, and I'm just gonna call it left-right earbud independence, because this is something that is a clear advantage that the Vistas have over the Jabras, is the fact that you can independently control each earbud. So if I have just one earbud in, I can listen to music and it works just fine, and then I can listen to the other one and they work the exact same. They're like mirror images of each other. Now they don't have as many playback controls as the Jabras because of that, but it's a really nice feature, and I wasn't sure if that was gonna be a make or break kind of deal with the Jabras. And after using for a while, I can say that it's actually not a make or break kind of feature. Honestly, there's just not that many situations where I wanna listen to just one earbud. The only reason why I could think of why you would need just one earbud in is because you need to hear somebody else. So for the Jaybirds, if you need to hear somebody else, you take out the earbud. But if you need to do that for the Jabras, you just turn on their hear-through feature and you can hear people around you. So you never need to take out one earbud. You can always just leave them in. And one nice thing that I like about the Jabras is the fact that if you take out the one earbud, the music stops playing. That's something that doesn't necessarily happen with the Jaybirds because they're independently controlled. So it's both a pro and a con, the fact that they're independently controlled. And if they just had the hear-through technology, you wouldn't need to take one earbud out. So it's a bit of a toss-up on this one, but I'm gonna have to give points in this category specifically, since it's called independent earbuds, I'm gonna have to give it to the Jaybirds Vista. So I'm gonna give them a check mark in this category, but I think we should talk about our next topic, which is going to be playback controls, because that's a big difference between these two. So let's start with the Jaybird Vista's controls. So if you wanna pause the music, you just tap once on either earbud and that plays or pause. If you double tap, that'll skip to the next song. And then if you long press, you have to choose between powering it down or raising and lowering the volume. And I feel like this is a problem because you have to actually go into your settings and you have to say, when I do a long press, does that shut it down? Or does that raise or lower the volume? And that's a problem because you shouldn't have to pick between the two. So you don't have that problem with the Jabras. The Jabras have different functions mapped to different earbuds. So I feel like there needs to be an option to tell each earbud to do something differently with a long press. So in the future, what I'd like to see Jaybird does is give me the option to say, like, I want this right one, when I press a long button press, I want that to shut it down. And then when I press long press this other one, I want it to do something else, like tape the volume up or down. So I feel like they need to update that in the future. And I know it's possible because the Galaxy Buds Plus have this option. Each one of the Galaxy Buds Plus is independently controlled, and each one can be set to whatever custom functions you want. And you can set a different custom function for the right one versus the left one. So I feel like the Jaybirds need to update that in the future. So let's go through the options on the Jabras for the playback controls. So if I have the right one and the left one, they both have a suite of different options. So they actually have more options than the Jaybirds because each one does several functions and each one does its own thing. So with the right one, you usually control all the playback options. So if you just tap once on the right one, it plays or pauses the music. If you double tap it, it skips ahead. And then if I want to skip back, I'd use the left one to double tap, skip back. And then on the right one, if I long press, it takes the volume up. On the left one, if I long press, it takes the volume down. If I want to turn the hear through on and off, I just tap once on the left side and it turns the hear through on or off. And then if I hold them both down together, it shuts them on and off and does pairing options. They also have separate options for like when you're in a phone call too. And one cool feature that the Jabras have is that when you're in the middle of a call, you can basically turn on a hear through like feature. I forget what it's called. I'll post a picture of it here. It starts with an S. But it basically lets you hear your own voice when you're in a call. So there's a little bit of a learning curve, but I'd rather have more options than less. And the Jabras offer a ton of options, almost a staggering amount of options at first, when you first get them. And they allow you to pretty much have complete control without actually having to like walk over to your phone. So like one problem that I have with the Jaybird Vistas is that if I'm listening to them and I'm turning up the volume up and down, the fact that I have that set to the long press on the Jaybird Vistas to being the volume up and down, that means that when I want to just shut them off, I have to walk over to my phone to shut them off. And I don't have to do that with the Jabras. So I think that the Jabras have the Jaybirds beat out in playback controls. Also, I should probably mention that both of these have Google, Alexa, and Siri integration, so really should have no issue if you're an Apple user using either one of these products. The Jabra and the Jaybird both have physical buttons, which is a feature that I really like. I don't really like the touch-based controls. Like, I think the Galaxy Buds and some other wireless earbuds use like touch-based controls. But if you're a runner and you have gloves on and you're trying to manipulate the buttons, it's not gonna work so well. So the fact that these click in is very easy, it's a very good feature. And one thing that I noticed about the Jabras is that they're really sensitive. So like, even though it's a physical press of a button, which is nice, it's a little bit sensitive. So like when you're first putting them in, you might have to get used to the fact that you could accidentally press the buttons, whereas I never had that issue with the Jabras. So I don't know if that's a feature worth mentioning or not for you guys, but physical buttons, I'm a fan of it, and both of these have that. That brings us on to our next category, which is GPS location abilities. So naturally, when you buy true wireless earbuds, one of the features that you're really worried about is the fact that you could easily lose them. So like when you use wireless earbuds like this that have a little strap behind them, when you're not using them, you can just wear them as like a little necklace around the house. And this worked when I had my Jaybird X2s, and same thing with these Plantronic Backbeat Fits. It's great because you're not gonna lose them. They're much easier to find. But these things are just tiny little earbuds. And a feature that I wish that they had was an easier way to locate them. So it's really nice that they have a GPS feature on them where I can call it up on the app. And I'll show you guys the pictures of what they have on the app here for locating. It basically shows you like a radius where you can find them based off of GPS. You can see exactly where they are on the map. But if they're buried underneath something, or you're out going for a run and they're like, you know, hidden in the grass, or they're buried in the sand or something like that, like you need some kind of auditory cue for finding these. And what I have for when I am trying to find like my car keys, for example, is something called the Tile app, okay? And that has like this little keychain attachment, and I'll show a picture of that too. But when I press that button on my keychain of my keys, I can find my phone, and I can also use my phone to find my keys and vice versa, because it makes a little beeping noise. And I feel like one big feature that's missing from here, from all these companies, is that they have a GPS option for finding these, but they don't have a little beeping noise. So I feel like auditory cues need to be implemented in the future, and that's a bit of homework that I'm giving both of these companies, Jabra and Jaybird. Oh gosh. It's one thing I learned from doing this video, it's how to properly pronounce the words Jabra and Jaybird. I mean, after a while, it's just a bunch of gibberish. It's a bunch of Jabra, Jaybird, Jibber, Jabber, Gibberish. Jabra, Jaybird, Jibber, Jabber, Gibberish. Try saying that 10 times fast. Jabra, Jaybird, Jibber, Jabber. That Jabra, Jaybird, Gibberish. Jaybird, Jabber, Jibber, Jabber, Jablas of the mind. Jabra and Jaybird both need to get on that game of the auditory cues for location finding. So I'll give them half a check for this category or something, because that's something they need to work on. So while we're talking about the topic of losing your earbuds and so on and so forth, I feel like that brings us on to our next category, which is portability and likelihood of losing, okay? I like the design of both of these cases. They're very good design. They're very easy to put in your pocket. They don't take up very much space. But I really feel like the Jabras missed the ball by not having a little attachment like this. And I actually haven't seen this on any of the other the earbud cases out there. And this is the first one that I know of that comes with this little loop. And this is actually a game changer. Like, I think that one of the biggest selling points that was made it tough for me to decide on which one to get initially when I was shopping online was like, is this thing a big deal? And in my opinion, I think it is. Because you're much less likely to lose this thing when it's attached to a loop. And this is actually such a thoughtful and good little innovation by Jaybird that I think that all the companies should start using these little loops so that you don't lose it. And what I'm gonna do with my Jabras here is I'm gonna try to use a little hack. I'm gonna try to use some Sugru, which is like a moldable silicone glue that you can buy online. And that's gonna dry and adhere to this. I'm gonna try to make my own little loop with my own little attachment on there. And I'm gonna see if I can mimic the design of these keychains. And I'll probably post something down below in the comments where you guys can see my little contraption. So if I had to give a point for design of the case and ease of use, I would definitely give it to the Jaybirds because of their little handy loop. Who would have thought that would have been such a big selling point? It's definitely an innovation that I want to see more companies making in the future. Okay, so on to probably the juiciest category of them all, which is sound quality. And since both of these sound very good, I wouldn't really say that one is the clear winner. But what I will say is that a lot of the reviews that I read online were that the Jabras were like super bass heavy and just completely drowned out the noise. But when I first tried them out, I kind of heard a little bit of that. But honestly, I think people online were a little bit overstated with that. So like a lot of the audiophiles would hate the fact that out of the box, these sound a little bit too bass heavy. But I actually don't mind that. And funny enough, I did the EQ test that was provided by Jaybird. And I found out that I don't hear bass very well and I need a little extra bass. So it actually sounded fine to me, but I've heard that a lot of people online just turn down the bass on in the EQ settings for the Jabras and they don't have any problems with it. So the Jabras may be snubbed by the audiophiles for having a really bass heavy EQ out of the box, but honestly, I don't think that's that big of a deal. I think out of the box, maybe the Jaybirds have a more balanced EQ, but honestly, the fact that the Jabras really have a huge bass output is a really big pro and not really a con because these things really kick out. I like the volume level of both of these. I think the Jabras sound a little bit louder at times, but honestly, both of these will just blow your ears out if you turn all the way up on a really good song, a loud song, so I'm not too worried about that. I have had issues in the past, like with my Plantronic Backbeats. That was one of the downsides of them, is they didn't get loud enough. Neither of these have that problem. They both get very loud, and thanks to the Jaybird Vista EQ, I was able to find out that my ears need a little extra bass, so maybe that's why I prefer the Jabras, I'm not sure. Now both of these have EQ settings in the apps, and they are both very cool, and they both allow you to customize your EQ exactly how you want it. One feature that I think the Jaybirds have over the Jabras is the fact that they have this cool little option where I'll show it up on the screen here, where you go into their app and you can, it just plays different cues and it tests out different parts of the audio spectrum to see how much of that your ears actually need. So for me, it turned out I actually needed more bass. I need a little bit brighter sounding audio and a little bit heavier bass than I would have expected. And it's really cool when you use this feature because the EQ makes it sound really good. So I think that a lot of people that compare these two, they try out the Vistas, and the Vistas with the custom EQ setting sounds amazing. So like when you compare that to just the Jabras out of the box, they sound a little bit better. But I think that where the Jabras really shine is when you're trying to do like a workout song that has a lot of bass, or you really need to crank it up and you really want to feel that rumble and you really want to feel like you're getting into the music and getting into that song. And when it comes to those pump up music kind of songs, so people that like to work out like that, I think the Jabras have them beat out. So for me personally, I like the Jabras a little bit better, but gosh, if these Jaybirds don't sound amazing when you put them on the custom EQ settings. So definitely I think that The Jabras need to have that in their app. And what's funny is they actually did announce that pretty soon, supposedly in Q2, which is right now of 2020, they're supposed to come out with an update that is supposed to update the sound app. And what's interesting is that Jabra is actually gonna try to mimic basically what's found in the Jaybird settings of the EQ, where they do that little special test. So the Jabra should be coming out with a firmware update pretty soon. It's not out yet. Hey guys, this is actually David from the future. I was about to release this video, and right before I did it, on May 29th, on May 28th, they released the update to the Jabra Elite 75T. They added two new features. They added the update to the My Sound feature that I was just talking about, where you can tailor the music to your individual hearing profile via a hearing test, and I'll show you guys. I kind of like Jaybird Vista's hearing test a little bit better, but the results that I got from doing the Jabra hearing test actually did improve the sound. So it's actually a very welcome addition, and I look forward to seeing what they come out with next year. They keep on improving these headphones constantly. The other major update that they added to the My Sound app was the My Controls portion, which lets you remap buttons to your earbuds. So you can single, double, or triple tab any button, and it doesn't matter which earbud it is or which accent it is, you get to completely customize what that action does. So you can actually add on extra functionality, and it just further adds customization options to the Jabra playback controls, which are already probably the best in the business. The one thing that they weren't able to update that I was looking forward to was the firmware update for the independent earbud use, so it could be just like the Jaybird Vistas where you could individually control them. And just from their internal testing, they found that people weren't really happy with the results when they used the independent earbuds. So perhaps next year when they roll out their next model, the Jaybird 85Ts or something like that, they might have that feature added on. But for now, this is exactly what I was just asking for Jabra to update with the custom EQ hearing test. So kudos to them for getting on that, and that pretty much puts them that much more over the edge over the Jaybird Vistas. I was going to give them a tie, but I think it's best to actually give the win to the Jabra in this category. They really have done a very good job with their updates, and they're only going to get better with time here, so I really look forward to seeing what they're going to do in the future. And while we're talking about the sound options, there's one option that I actually forgot to mention with the Jabras is that they have what's called soundscapes. So if you want to mask the noise around you, you can actually pick between pink noise, white noise, the sound of a fan, nice waterfall, or you can just listen to the sounds of nature, and they actually sound pretty good. So if you don't have any music, you can still block out your surroundings even if there's no music to play. So for the category of sound quality, I definitely say that both of these have their own special features, and it really just depends on what sounds best to you. But I'm gonna have to say it's a tie, just because the Jaybird Vistas have better EQ settings, but the Jabras have that really sweet, sweet bass. And if you're a bass lover, I don't think it's any question that you need to get the Jabras over the Jaybirds, but gosh, they both sound really good. And I think I'm kind of leaning towards the Jabras, just because when I really need to get into a good workout and I really need that intensity, I need that little bit extra bass. Really, they both sound excellent. You're not gonna be disappointed with either one of them. They both sound amazing for these little tiny earbuds, and I'm gonna give them a check for both being winners in this category. So our 10th and final category is one that I really don't know if it really deserves to have its own category, but price is our final category. And honestly, when you're at this price range, like anything above $150, you just want the best, okay? If you're trying to get like some kind of crazy audiophile thing, go with the $450 Bose earbuds or something like that. But honestly, I think that at this price range, we're trying to compete with things like AirPod Pros and stuff like that. And both of these have the AirPod Pros definitely beat out. They're both $50 to $70 cheaper. The Jabras are $200 and the Jaybirds are $180. If you're really trying to split about the price and you know you don't really care about like things like waterproofness, there's better options down at the $150 range where you can get the Galaxy Buds Plus for $150. So if you don't care about waterproofing, just get that one. You'll save like $50. And they have the same features as like the Vista, where they're independently controlled. They actually have more a longer playback time and more personalization options. But honestly, if you're at that like $180, $200 range, okay, that's right where these babies are sitting at. And these both have like the $200 Sonys beat out in like pretty much every category. So I would say when you're getting close to that $180, $200 range, these things are pretty sweet. But if $20 really makes that big of a difference to you, I don't think you should probably be shopping in the $200 category. But that being said, if you're trying to compare like the $250 AirPods and you're trying to compare them to something like the Jaybird Vistas, if you want to save like 70 bucks, that's a pretty big chunk of change. You could probably like buy the Jaybird Vistas and then buy like one of these other really good $70 earbuds, and then you have two sets of earbuds. So that's something to think about. But technically, if you were to make this its own category, the Jaybird Vistas would beat the Jabras out in price. But honestly, like they do have the 75T Elites, which aren't the active versions, and they're the same price as the Jaybirds pretty much. So it's kind of a toss up. If you really like Jabras and you really like that bass profile and you want something at the same price as the Jaybirds, you do have that option. It's just, in my opinion, I think you should get something that has an IP7 waterproof rating. But that's just my opinion. And with that, we have wrapped up our categories. So I hope that was a pretty thorough breakdown of both of the earbuds for you guys. We're gonna tally it all up here. And if you look and we tally it all up, I think there's a pretty clear winner. And that winner is, drumroll please, the Jabra Elite Active 75Ts. I was kind of surprised by this one, to be honest with you guys, because I was a Jaybird fan before this video was made, and before I ever ordered them, I thought this would be a more clear-cut decision. And honestly, both of them were very good, in my opinion, but just certain factors of the Jabra, like the hear-through technology, and a little bit better bass, and just the fact that it was just as waterproof when I thought it wasn't as waterproof, kind of blew my mind. So I would say that if you can overlook the fact that there's a master and slave function, which again, I don't think is that big of a deal, I think that you'd really enjoy the Jabras. And I really think for all the reasons that we mentioned in this video, they are the best true wireless earbuds of 2020. And they have pretty much every category checked. So unfortunately, the Jaybirds got beat out a little bit. They're still amazing earbuds. I don't think you're gonna have any qualms about buying either one of these, but I have to crown the king of 2020 as the Jabra Elite 75 Active Ts. You are the best earbuds of 2020. And I really think that Jabra has a lot of potential in the future to become the best in every category. Really the only things that they're lacking is active noise cancellation and the fact that they don't have independent control of either earbud. So if you guys agree, let me know down in the comments below. Let me know what you guys think and what experiences you've had. Do you think it's a big deal that the Jaybird Vistas don't have things like extra bass? Do you think that it's a big deal that these are not independently controlled? Because in my opinion, it's not a big deal. So hopefully you guys found this video helpful. If you liked this video, make sure that you like. If you want to subscribe to my channel, I have a ton of fitness content that's coming out in the future. I've already done some stuff on exercise programming, but we're also putting out some nutrition videos, and I plan on doing a lot more product reviews in the future because I have a full gym full of really cool products that you may not have even heard of before, and I'm going to be reviewing them in the future. So definitely stay tuned for that. Comment down below with any of your thoughts, suggestions, feedback, and I look forward to seeing you guys in the next video. Until then, remember, you only have one life to live. See you later, guys.